Hello, my quilting friends. My name is Leah Day, and today I'm quilting Neverland. This is basically a variation of twisted squares, only instead of straight lines, I'm stitching curvy lines. And what I'm doing basically is stitching a curvy square in the middle of a regular square. I'm gonna back up here so that way you can see the entire thing. Here we go. All right, so I'm right now on the edge and I'm going to stitch that curvy line, and I'm kind of wiggling and angling outward so that way I'll hit about a little bit more than a quarter inch up that next line, just like that. Okay, and now I'm just gonna continue kind of spiraling my way inside. So from this point, I'm going to wiggle gradually, kind of growing the width between those two lines until I hit the next line. And you just keep on going around and around and around, and you can kind of start to echo. And I think that's gonna add to the effect too. So echoing is just stitching a set distance from another line. In this case, we're kind of enlarging the echo as we go, but I'm mirroring image. So basically I'm stitching the same curve as I widen that out. And now we're starting our third line. You can see we have two sets of lines going in here. Now I'm gonna start the third line. And so I'm just echoing, I'm trying to stitch that same curving line, but I'm widening the space between them. It's very, very simple, and you can see just how fast this is. I'm moving really quickly with this design, and I really like how this flows. I also really like this texture. So where is this gonna work? Where is Neverland going to fit well in your quilts? Well, I think any square shape, let's say you have a quilt block and it's got a nice big square in the middle, fill it up with Neverland. That's gonna be a really easy design. You can start on the outer edges, work your way to the inside, then you break your thread. Super, super simple. This isn't gonna be a great design to quilt in your borders, just simply because, you know, it fits that square shape. I think an applique shape though, like a circle, something like that, could also work well. You just have to pick your points and maybe draw a square inside of it or some other shape inside of it, and that's how you'll base off and create your wiggly lines. So yeah, this is working out really well. It's one of those funny things, you know, when we stitch a design with straight lines and it works out well and it's an easy design to stitch, you know, you might think that that's it, but there's always at least one variation, and that is to go from straight lines to curvy lines. So always give that a try. If you come up with a design and you're playing with it and you really like it, then always consider switching it from curvy lines to straight lines or straight lines to curvy lines. So here I'll zoom in just a bit so you can see how things change as I really get tight into the center section. And this is where things can go just a little bit weird, and you just have to be careful and mindful of the rules of the design. So the rule of the design is to stitch a wiggly line, gradually widening the distance between that line and the line before it so that you end further away than you started. So that's the rule of the design. As long as you keep that in your head, even when the space gets smaller, it's going to work out fine. So I'm just trying to focus on that. Another thing that's, you know, can be confusing is if you do any travel stitching. You know, a lot of designs will travel stitch, and I even caught myself making that mistake at first, and I had to remind myself, nope, we're just going point to point. I just hit a point and stitch in another direction. I just hit that point and stitch in another direction. And you can bring these lines just a little closer together as you come into the center. That can look good too. We're almost there. So I think just two more lines there and there, and then I'd probably end it right there. You don't wanna break it up too much or you'll kind of compact that center section just a bit. So there we go, that's Neverland. So that's it for Quilting Neverland. I really hope you enjoyed learning how to quilt this design. Learn more about the sewing machine that I'm using in this video at leahday.com/sew20. Yes, you can free motion quilt your own quilts on an inexpensive home machine. Until next time, let's go quilt.